Oh man, how long has it been since I've seen this screen? And this just takes me way back. But anyway, hey everyone, welcome back. And we are looking at a PS2 game. One of which that probably started the whole PlayStation 2 collection spree. In fact, the whole PlayStation 2 kind of just brought back memories, to be honest. But enough dilly-dallying. Let's get started for what we all came here for. And it actually feels nice to have like the usual screen working because the last time I tried recording off of my PS2, the wires were a little funky, so not only did the screen display a little weird, it also caused the capture card to act a little funny. But welcome to, man, one of my f something that I really love to play back all the time, and something that I've been trying to go back to. Welcome to Kingdom Hearts, a game that pretty much has become famous as time itself, as if I remember correctly. And oh god, this game, there are really no words. There are a lot of words to be said about this. From being an unexpected project to being something that was doomed to fail, and now look at it. Look how far you've come, and it all started here. Alright, but just a couple things I should say before we get started. This is the original version on the PS2. It's not 1.5 HD Remix, which includes the final mix version of Kingdom Hearts and a couple of other games that I happen to own in the series. So think of this as mainly the original version. I do know a little bit of details regarding 1.5 Remix, so if I happen to come across anything, I will do my best to cover it. But I'm gonna be mainly sticking to what I know from the original game and most differences that I know of. So if you're using this as a guide, or you just happen to follow along, please know that most of the stuff that you'll be seeing in the original game only applies in the original game. 1.5 changed up a lot, so I will try and cover it as much as I can. So let's get started. Gonna be tackling an expert. If you are playing 1.5, you'll have the proud mode difficulty, which is roughly a little bit harder than that. It's either proud or maniac. One of those two. But there's another difficulty higher than that. Gonna rock on expert. I usually don't like vibration. And let's go ahead and get started. And I know this song is super copyrighted, so I'm not sure how it's gonna play out. But I'm just gonna go ahead and mute myself so you guys can enjoy the music.
I've been having these weird thoughts lately. Like, is any of this for real or not?
Thank you.
Well, aren't you the most jerkish way to greet a new player? But here we go. Let's go ahead and get started by going on. And right away, we have a choice to make. So it seems. Alright, you have, right off the bat, you have a choice as to what you want. Gonna go ahead and get through the tutorials. You have a choice between three weapons. Whichever one you pick will not only affect our protagonist here, how he levels up, but also what abilities he'll learn. If you go with the sword, consider yourself mainly learning combat abilities first, and prioritizing other stuff like magic and support skills later. You go with the staff, you're gonna be more of a mage with very wide range of support skills, and in final mix, the abilities change drastically. But for the original game, just think of this as like a weird blend of both physical and support skills. You generally learn more active battle support skills rather than usual support skills that you might know from other games. You go with the shield, consider yourself a tank because you are loaded to the brim with support skills, which are usually along the lines of gathering goodies and other things. And for this playthrough, I'm gonna go with my tried and true favorite whenever I pick up this game. The staff. Or the power of the mystic. So many people I knew always went with the sword or the shield or some combination of sword. So I'm going with the staff. Once you make your choice, you need to give up something, which not only affect... I already got my staff, but now I need to make a choice on what I want to give up. Either give up defense and become a mixed attacker, or give up a strength for rebound stats. And just like how I usually do it in every time I play through this game, I go with the staff and give up the sword. This combination in particular gives me pretty balanced stats, which may or may not be appealing to some, but I usually tend to go for the balanced stat trope as a whole. Oh joy. Again, I apologize for the lack of commentary, it's just... Part of this is just me reliving some of the games I just grew up with, so I'm just... kinda standing back here and... just looking back on how many memories I have. With that said, there's our weapon. Let's go ahead and bash some. Let's go ahead and bash something. Alright, get some little tutorial stuff out of the way. Have a bit of health and have a bit of magic. Nothing really new. Now I have a little... Kinda looks adorable when you look at it one way. Let's go ahead and take it out. All you do is just walk on and bash it out. Again, this is mainly the tutorial level and... I know a lot of people have played Kingdom Hearts, so I don't think I should go too in-depth as to what the mechanics are just yet, because this whole section right here is doing a really good job of summing up what I would say anyway. Like right now, we're going to teach you how to lock on by pushing R1, and you pretty much have your eyes on whatever enemy you're locked onto all the time. Get used to this because this will make fights a lot easier. Also, sweet, it took out one guy. Ah, come on. Come on, take it down. Ah, I just have to say, like... oh, wait, I don't remember seeing that. I swear you could come up with a Final Fantasy joke about going to the void with that. But now we go to a new panel, something that looks akin to, if I can get a better picture. Let's... Sleeping Beauty? Think it's from Sleeping Beauty. Oh. Anyway, slight change for Final Mix. In Final Mix, you have Reaction Command, so you just need to push triangle. Original, you're gonna need to use this fourth field command, which is usually reserved for something else in Final Mix. Let's have a quick look around, and we have a little treasure chest. Let's go ahead and open up this bad boy. We get nothing. Oh, we got a giant crate. Go ahead and give it a shove. That I'm down for. And now I have items. So, you haven't really caught on. Kingdom Hearts is not really a traditional RPG, but more so of an action RPG. You have your weapon out at all times, and you can pretty much just run around and explore and attack. Later games kind of change up the formula a bit, but for now, just think of it more so as I'm ready, I can be hit anytime, so stay on your guard. Now we have that door fixed after getting used to some more controls. Kinda glad I'm not playing this in the dark, cause... jeez, that's like the whole movie effect that happens when you play through... when you come out of the movies. Ah, first day of introductions. Oh, that's right, I forgot about first person view. These guys look familiar, don't you think? Well, you two were made for upcoming game, that's pretty much mainstay, and also got a re-release not too long ago. But you look younger than usual. Again, if you play Final Mix, you have reaction commands. But what do you have to say for yourself? What's important to me? Of these threes, I value friendship. Maybe not to the right person, but that varies. Okay, what do you have to say? Ooh, of these three. Dude, you have no idea. Alright, Blitzball Man, what do you have to say? I would like to be strong. Uh-huh. Yeah. True. What do you have to say for me? Sure, I like that. Quit being cryptic. I don't have time for cryptic messages. Oh, wait, no. I think this might have been Sleeping Beauty or some sort. Here, I have a little light. Let's go ahead and check it out. Start to save. Alright. Usual game stuff. Now we have ourselves some little baddies. Let's go. Ooh, quite a number of them. Usual trick Supplies? One thing I should mention about this area. Don't worry if you do end up losing all your health. You should be fine. Up until... Actually, no, I completely forgot about that. They already gave you the warning. But there are moments that even if you do lose your health, you will be fine. And I'll get to those in a moment, when we get there. This is not one of them, so keep your guard up, lock onto an enemy, and then go for broke. Now we have our little save point. Save points and... Man, this game's already covering what I'm about to say. Can pretty much save and get into the habit of saving often if you're completely new to this stuff. But after accessing the save point, we have our new glass tile staircase. That leads to another pillar, and I'm gonna go ahead and save. Got a new memory card just for this game. Or just for pretty much stream and everything. That way I won't conflict with some of the data I already have for the main game. And 15 minutes, alright. Not bad. Kind of not speedrun level. You don't have to save... You don't have to save to continue on the path, but the game gives you a chance to do so. But let's carry on this path and see where it takes us. And actually, if you look back, staircase is gone. We have no choice but to move on. And this is a Disney character I know full well. I see. Hello, Giant Shadow! And it's not like you come from the inside of my inner self that I want to reject and hide from everyone. No, not like that at all. Be pretty ridiculous if that was the case. Well, let's get started by taking down this Giant Shadow. Alright, always starts off by charging his fist. Then once he slides down, jump to dodge that- Oh man, I actually got hit by that. When he slides his fist, go right up and hit the head. You get a bunch of experience and you're dealing way more damage than usual. We'll deal with the little guys later because this is our chance for more damage. You can hit the arms, but I prefer hitting the head. Alright. Oh man, I forgot about the whole- I am not dying to this target. Alright. Keep an eye on that target. We're good. Alright, first level up. Can't believe I actually had to use an item on this boss. We do get a level up, so make sure you take care of those bags if you want more experience. Same trick as before, gonna get out of the way this time. And same thing before, right up that arm and go for that extra experience. It is possible to level up twice if depending on the choices you made earlier. And I'll get to those choices after we get through alive. For now, let's go ahead and just take care of these shadows. More experience, we get more health, among other things. One thing to note about this particular version, the camera is regulated to the R1 and R2. Oh, L2 and R1 buttons, so you get used to that, and the right stick is reserved for switching commands. Anyway, you should fire some stuff out of his chest. Just wait for your timing. Now come, swing, you get a bunch of stuff to him. And just like that, we're done. Get that final strike! Now I rob no weapon. We are stuck. We still reject our inner self. Not quite hoping. Not anymore, it seems. The one who will open the door. I'll keep that in mind. Ah, but look at that bright sunny sky, and we're alive! Pretty surreal, don't you think?
Whoa!
Jerk.
Give me a break, Iris. So are you, lazy bum. I knew that I'd find you snoozing down here.
No, this huge black thing swallowed me up. I couldn't breathe, I couldn't... Ow!
Are you still dreaming?
It wasn't a dream. Or was it? I don't know. What was that place? So bizarre.
Yeah, sure.
Totally brushed it off like nothing happened.
What was your hometown like? You know, where you grew up?
I've told you before. I don't remember.
Nothing at all?
Nothing.
You ever want to go back?
Well, I'm happy here.
Really?
But you know, I wouldn't mind going to see it.
I'd like to see it too. Along with any other worlds out there. I want to see them all.
Sounds like a bad wish, Sora.
Hey! Aren't you guys forgetting about me? So, I guess I'm the only one working on the raft. And you're just as lazy as he is.
So you noticed. Okay, we'll finish it together. I'll race you.
Huh?
What? Are you kidding?
Ready? Go!
Yeah, sure, why not? Take the jump. But now, for the second time, welcome to Kingdom Hearts! And, jeez, it was so hard trying to not exactly delve into specific plot details or anything, among other things. But, welcome to a new area, Destiny Islands, and, Jesus, this game just really goes on and on. Ah, there's just so much to say about this one! Now we're back with Sora, taking control, and instead of having that cool staff we picked up earlier, we have a wooden sword. Kind of a downgrade if you ask me. But I guess given the current standards, that's to be expected. Anyway, a couple of things I should go mention. Since we went with the staff, our stats are pretty balanced and nothing really too special to speak of. Again, your stats will vary depending on what you picked up at the beginning. If you picked up the sword, expect your... Excuse me for a sec. Your stats will vary depending on what combination you have, but your main priority and what you learn will be based on what you picked first. So if you kept the sword and shield, you'll consider your strength and defense be pretty up to snuff. But what would change later on is what you would get depending on what you picked first. You prioritize the sword, or if you chose the sword early on, you'll prioritize combat abilities later on. And if you pick the shield, you'd get support abilities later on. But we don't exactly have anything at the moment, and we're still stuck with our wooden sword. And we do have things to do regarding the raft, and you can't talk to Kairi for a list. I won't, because I do know where most of the areas are. Go ahead and pick up this log. This is stuff for the raft. There are 4 items you can get at this point, and we also have a little bit of remap. A little bit of fights to do. Hey there, dude.
Hey, what's happening, man?
And this is Waka from Final Fantasy X. And you have another guy from Final Fantasy X. And over there's Selfie or Selefie from Final Fantasy VIII, I believe? But essentially, if we talk to the Final Fantasy characters again, we get to have a little sparring session.
Show me your stuff!
Walk up fights with Blitz Balls! And you can pretty much beat the whole fight the same way we handled that giant shadow. Just hit that Blitz Ball right back at him. And this whole strategy becomes important for one fight later on. Alright, I thought I had it. Oh, I should've got hit. Come on, throw another Blitz Ball. You don't even have to get close to him, you can just spam the whole Blitz Ball tactic. You get experience for hitting the ball back at him as well as later on. Oh god! I'm not losing this fight! I really wish I did get to- Ah, I'm gonna have to close in, aren't I? Oh, actually no I don't. Ah, screw it. So there you go, just hit the Blitz Ball back in for more experience. And you get some experience when you beat Waka. Only tech you need to worry about is that charge of Blitz Ball, which you can hit back at him for added damage. Well, let's go ahead and talk to Selfie.
Ah, the breeze feels great.
And like a little touch for the Final Fantasy characters is that they actually use like modified version of their actual weapons. Selfie uses a jump rope where she used nunchakus. Oh, what you didn't? Wait for your jump, then you can hit the jump rope for more experience. Then you can go for a combo. Very easy to exploit, and we get another level. That makes us level 4. And wow, we got through that fight pretty easy. Selfie is a lot easier to get tech points, and you get 2 if you take advantage of the whole jump rope tactic. And let's see here. Level 54. Alright, we're doing pretty good. We have one more other opponent to fight for a duel, but before we get there, let's go ahead and explore for a little bit. And like, while we're there, I just have to say, this is still my favorite remix of, or take on Destiny Islands. You get to hear, later games do feature this theme as a whole, but I really love the whole first take on they did with Kingdom Hearts. And I really wish they stuck with this particular edition as opposed to the later ones, even if they do sound a lot more relaxing and more fitting with the setting. Now, let's go ahead. We have a little cloth that you can get in that little shack up there. And we should get something like a rope around here. Awesome. Go ahead and pick up the rope. Let's go ahead and talk to Tidus.
Hey, Sora! You feel lucky today?
Tidus from Final Fantasy X, and a little neat touch. Usually wields a longsword in his game, but here he has like a little red dual stick that's roughly close to the color of his longsword. Alright, Tidus! He definitely hits the hardest out of all of them. But you do have like... You can tech most of his stuff, but you can't exactly exploit it and get damage. And he's kind of like a showboat, like he would be in his... grown self. But it's usually just a matter of baiting it out. You can only counter like when he decides to rush you. Get your usual combo and we get some added experience.
Oh man, I'm really off today.
The fights are not one and done barring one particular character, which we will get to later. But if you beat all 3 Final Fantasy characters, we can do a 3-on-1 fight. But before we do that, let's go ahead and take care of one little thing that most people usually don't do whenever I see playthroughs of this game. See this barrel? Let's go ahead and pick it up. And throw it onto the beach. Alright, this should do. Now let's go meet up with Tidus. Come on, Sora. Climb up that rope. Or that pole. A little bit not used to playing this after getting used to the whole camera, especially with the right analog stick. But oddly enough, I prefer having a certain style that you would see in later games. Alright, you three against me, Tidus!
Let's get it!
Alright, get Guaca into view. Hit him with a blitzball. Come on, Guaca, work with me here. Hit Tidus with a blitzball, he will be stunned. Ah, oh, darn, I'm way too far. Ow. Jeez, I'm getting cornered. As soon as I start talking trash, that's when I get the best of me. Ow. Throw that blitzball. Oh, I got Guaca instead. Not who I wanted. But if you hit Tidus with the blitzball, you do stun him a lot longer than you would with Guaca. That's why I try to keep him between. But you want to be a jerk, jump on this barrel. Usually you can jump through your way through all of it. Or you can use the barrel to stun Tidus for a bit. Oh, I actually got it. Come on, throw another one. I swear I actually got- Oh, I actually lost!
I think we overdid it.
Ah, so much for that tactic. Alright, let's go again. Because I know that's how I usually fight those three. Run past it, and hit the blitzball to Tidus. So it goes from a 3-on-1, a 2-on-1. Alright. You can actually hit Celephi with the blitz balls. She won't get stunned, but it does make for some pretty interesting tactics. You just have to deal with Waka's layout, and oh great, he woke up. Alright, come on. Come on. Throw that blitz ball. Ow. Ah, not exactly in a favorable position. Alright, one more try before I'll do the usual tactic.
Let's get him! You ready?
Ah, I actually hit him. Oh, that was... Nope. Alright. Throw that blitzball, Guaca. Oh sweet, we actually stunned him. Yeah, keep it up, Guaca. Throw those blitz balls. Should keep Tidus down for a bit. Leave him alone. Throw that blitz ball again. Okay, that actually hurts. Jeez. Ah, drat.
Hey, you guys, I think we overdid it.
Alright, come on, one more time. I really like the whole blitzball strategy because it turns the 3-on-1 to a 2-on-1. But it's not being really effective right now. Darn. Ouch. And also, when you hit him with a blitzball, the timer resets itself, so you don't have to worry about him waking up for a while. Leave you alone. Ah, stop overshooting it, Guaca. Alright, that leaves Celephi alone. Let's go ahead and take her down. Alright, should be awake by now. Let's go ahead and refill that stock on... Stay asleep, Tidus! Alright. Now let's get rid of Tidus. Come on, keep throwing those blitz balls. Oh, come on! This actually, this not only stuns him, but it actually lowers his health. Keep it up, Waka. It's working. You build up a lot of bonus experience. Come on, throw one to me. Other way. Ah, Dry, he woke up! Come on. You are rewarded if you win the 3-on-1, and it shouldn't take as long as I'm making it, but that's because of my strategy. Or lack thereof. Not quite the person I want to hit. Sweet! Actually got him! Well, let's take care of Celephi. Oh jeez. Come on, throw me one, Waka. Ah, she took the hit for him! Oh wait, did I actually get Celephi with the Blitz Ball? Come on, this strategy works really well, it's just not usually cooperating with Snee right now. The whole idea with the strategy between these three is essentially Tidus becomes the front lines and Celephi just sneaks in the hit. Waka becomes the long range hitter. Because he's not cooperating, I'll stun him. Come on. Not exactly working out. The main way you can do this is just go after whoever's near you. But I usually like the stun strategy more. It usually works well. Keep him a little quiet. Come on, throw me another one. Keep it up, Waka. It's working. Oh, you shielded him! You fool! Okay, I actually got that blitz ball hit. Now let's get rid of Tidus. Throw me another one. Another! I might be a little overleveled for later on. Actually close enough to not be affected. Still not enough to human. I think he throws a lot sooner than usual. Oh sweet, now it actually takes him down. Now it becomes business as usual. I can actually get the hit on him. I don't know why, but I find that hidden animation hilarious. Alright, let's see now. Ah! Yay, it actually worked!
I can't believe we lost!
But being those three gives you a potion! And you can rematch them to get more potions. But we also have another way of getting them. And it's also actually home to where we need to go next to get the final material. Also, how well are we doing right now? We are level 6. Alright, not bad. Maybe a little overleveled than we're supposed to be at the moment, but we should be fine. But what you also need to come here for is this log. Go ahead and pick it up, and we have our little resident jerk here, chilling out. Sure you did. Alright, sure. Now, beating Riku nets you a potion, but he's also kind of one of the toughest ones. Just run circles around him, you should be fine. Only other thing you need to worry about is that every 4 hits actually puts him in a knockdown position.
We still don't got it.
He also likes to move around a lot.
Come on.
Oh geez, that... But other than that, Riku's not that bad. And you can't hit him when he jumps. He's around. So this isn't really too bad. You just have to worry about if Riku sticks to the corners. Oh, and if you fall off, you lose the round. Definitely nowhere near as evil as the 3-on-1. And you get a potion for winning, so this makes a really good spot to level up to get potions. And plus, 5 experience for beating Riku is not that bad. Alright, that's like 2. This one knocks him down, run around. Oh, that kick does a lot more than I remember. You're safe if you do the whole 3-hit combo when he's knocked down. Oh, you didn't go for it. One thing to note is that as his health gets lower, he will start doing the knockdown a lot more frequently. Like right there, I only hit him twice and he just went down. Or actually, I think I hit him 4 times anyway. Alright, sweet. That's 3 potions and... I'll go one more just for the road. Yeah, one more time. I usually like having 3 potions, plus the whole experience does help out later on.
Don't tell me you're giving up already.
2, 3, get out of the way! Be careful if Riku's at the edge, you can pretty much fall off. Also, running away does count as a forfeit in all those matches. Awesome. Actually got hit by that drop kick. Oh, actually no, I'm not kidding, he does do it more frequently. But overall, Riku's not that bad. More manageable than the 3-on-1. But we got everything we need. We got our potions, which I'm gonna go ahead and equip on Sora. You never know when you might need them. And let's carry on with our daily chores. Oh, one quick thing. If for whatever reason you want to save your game, Just head inside the shack, and you can save right here. I don't need a save right now, so I think we're good. So, with all our stuff in hand, our two logs, our cloths, and a rope, let's go ahead and talk to Kairi. If you didn't know what to do, you can go talk to Kairi and she'll help you out. You get a hide potion for your rewards. And sure. And now, cutscene time!
So, Kairi's home is out there somewhere, right?
Could be. We'll never know by staying here.
But how far Fair enough.
Who knows? If we have to, we'll think of something else.
So, suppose you get to another world. What would you do there?
Well, I haven't really thought about it. It's just, I've always wondered why we're here, on this island. If there are any other worlds out there, why did we end up on this one? And suppose there are other worlds.
Pretty sure you had a good reason to come here.
Then ours is just a little piece of something much greater. So, we could have just as easily ended up somewhere else, right?
I don't know.
Exactly. That's why we need to go out there and find out. Just sitting here won't change a thing. It's the same old stuff. So let's go.
You've been thinking a lot lately, haven't you?
Thanks to you. If you hadn't come here, I probably would have never thought of any of this. Kairi, thanks.
You're welcome.
I think that's kind of a lie now, given the whole... recent games.
You wanted one, didn't you?
Paupu fruit?
If two people share one,
Star fruit. I swear there's actually a name for that
remain
fruit.
A part of each other's lives, no matter what. Come on, I know you want to try it.
What are you talking?
Oh man. You know what's... I don't think we ever see that fruit or that thing ever mentioned again. But now, as we continue on with plot, we have more and... Oh man, the whole thing that turned everybody's heads at when this was first announced. Square and Disney working together. Whoever saw that coming? And back when this was first announced and everything, everybody said this was going to be terrible. At least in my area, anyway. I don't know, something about it drew me interested, and I got it anyway. Hello there, Pluto. Kind of like neat little detail, like how the whole statues for Donald and Goofy kind of look like some of the Final Fantasy classes from previous games. Like the Duck Mage kind of looked like the Black Mage, and I want to say the Knight looked like the Fighter class from the classic games too. Oh, that's the Goofy I remember. That too.
Hey there, Donald. Good morning.
We've got a problem, Goofy. But don't tell anyone.
Queen Minnie?
Not even the Queen.
Lazy?
No! It's top secret!
Oh, good morning, ladies!
What?
Yep, good old Goofy to blow our cover just like that. I'm just surprised how true the character they stay with the whole Disney characters, considering that how most crossovers tend to work. But oh well. Anyway, back on the island, back playing as Sora. Day 2 of whole gathering the raft. What we need to do is go over there to where Kairi was yesterday. But we have a little bit of business to do here also. And unlike last time, we can't do everything in one go, so we do have to actually talk to her. What do you have to say, Seleffi?
Hey Sora, have you heard about the legendary power of the Paupu fruit? They say if you share it with someone you really care for, it binds you together forever and ever, through eternity. It's so romantic. I gotta try it sometime.
Oh man, that old Papa Fruit took a new level, didn't it? Alright, in all seriousness though, if you want to rematch with any of the Final Fantasy characters, you have the power to do so. You can even do the 3-on-1 since Tidus is now over there. But what we're mainly here for, let's go ahead and take care of some item goodies. Get some fish from the ocean. They're usually right around here, so you don't have to stray too far. And if they're not showing up, you can just hang around and wait, and there's always the good old leave and come back. I think you need like 3 of these, so swim around until you find any. Good thing Sora can swim, or we'd be kind of screwed out of getting items. And there should be one right here. Really, it's been a while, so I don't exactly remember where all the goodies are, but I'll do my best. Also, Tidus relocated here. What do you have here?
I think you've gotten stronger, but odds are you're still no match for Riku.
Dude, you should have saw me yesterday!
One last time. He whipped us all.
Like I did?
Well, I guess Kairi can always count on him.
Ah, poor Sora. Always the middleman of the group, aren't ya? Well, 2 insinuates the way that the second game insinuates high school life is kind of interesting for those 5. Anyway, we have a leg up there. Let's go ahead and nab it. Not quite sure what it's for. It could belong to a seagull or something. But let's go ahead and grab it. Oh, it is for a seagull. Well, it's good breakfast. Pretty sure it has like plenty of iron or something. Hey, Waka, what's up?
Me and Tidus, we are gonna do a little exploring today. You know, to the secret place at the base of that tree. There's gotta be something there, yeah?
You read my mind. But we will get there later. Let's see. I want to say there's another fish, or if we just need only 2. Because I know you're going to need fish, I know you need that seagull egg, and the rest of the items you won't be able to get till later. Ah, here it is! Alright, sweet. Got all the fish we need. Let's take up Waka's offer and head on over to the secret place. And also jump over people, so if you're into that, you can do that quite a bit. Inside this pretty deep cave. And we are here to go look for some mushrooms. Also, cave art, everybody. Still a lot better than mine, actually. And oh, dude, that's actually pretty nice. Let's see here. I've always been interested in little stuff like this, so pardon my progress if you just see me looking around. Bit of a house. A little plant. I swear I've seen that somewhere. And wait, what? Huh. That doesn't look familiar at all, doesn't it? And this one has fish, a couple of new stuff. Alright, what we're mainly here for is mushrooms, but we also have something pretty nice. I really hope those mushrooms are edible. Good lord. Lord knows what happens when you eat a poison fungus. Good try, Sora. Gotta work on those art skills. I could actually use the same also. Aw, look at that. He did get better.
Who's there?
I've come to see the door to this world.
Huh?
This world has been connected.
What are you talking about?
Tied to the darkness. Soon to be completely eclipsed.
Well, whoever you are, stop freaking me out like this. Huh? Well, where did you come from?
You do not yet know what lies beyond the door.
So you're from another world.
There is so very much to learn. You understand so little.
Oh yeah? Well, you'll see. I'm gonna get out and learn what's out there.
A meaningless effort. One who knows nothing can understand nothing.
A bold statement for you. And he's gone. Disappeared into the ether. Oh well, what do you have to say, Sora? Actually, one thing I forgot to do is that if you look at this door before picking up the mushrooms in that cutscene, Sora will actually comment a couple of things about this door. Mainly about how where this goes and how someone could get in, since there's no door or lock. Anyway, we got what we needed here. Got some mushrooms, got some fish, got a seagull egg for breakfast. Pretty sure that can feed like 3 people. But anyway, if you talk to the Final Fantasy characters, you can challenge them for rematches, or in Waka's case, he'll actually give you a hit. Most of which you'll cover most of the stuff that you know of. But I guess the most important thing would be that if you lock on to something, you can stay on, which is my usual preferred preference of fighting. Anyway, got what we need here? Let's go ahead and take on to this spot. And lo and behold, Riku is here. We can't challenge him to swordplay anymore, but we got something else to do here. Before we do, let's go ahead and march around a bit. Leave that thing right there, because we will be needing that later on. And I prefer to do this now before we take care of any of the other interactables. There are plenty of ways to get around through this big area, but I want to wait until we need them later.
Come on.
Chuck this thing over there. Okay, good, I didn't break it. Hold up, climb on that ledge, and we get a free treasure chest. Gives you a protect chain, raises your defense by 1 point. And while that might not seem like much, Any point of defense is always appreciated. Let's hang around here again. So we can move crates, we can move boulders. Zora's pretty strong despite being kind of scrawny looking, if you ask me. And we got another set of mushrooms. Next thing we need is some more coconuts. And actually, I'll put that on hold. Hey, Gert. Way ahead of you. Also, I know where he is too. Now that we have a main objective, let's go back and find Riku. Alright, bud, what's up? Good point. Not bad. I don't mind Excalibur. But you have a choice to name the raft. And I usually leave it alone and just call it Excalibur, but... I actually don't know. We'll keep it simple. Excalibur. I mean, I've heard of interesting names, I've heard of Fusion, I've heard of... Actually, the only thing that I know of is Fusion. I don't know what other people try to call the raft. But this time around... All you do is now erase instead of going swordplay. Touch that star and we win!
If I win, I'm captain. And if you win...
I get to share the Palpu with Kairi.
Huh?
Deal? The winner gets to share a Palpu with Kairi.
Oh, wait a minute. Okay, on my count.
Time for a little race, and remember that stuff I told you to leave alone? Well, now they come into play. Being Riku shouldn't be too bad. And while he usually goes for the stairs, I want to climb that ladder. And provided I don't screw this up, I should have a really big shortcut. Alright, didn't screw it up. Oh man, am I screwed up. Now I have a bit of a platform and... Riku, no! Alright, almost there. Touch that star. And then just platform your way to victory. Oh no! This is workable, as long as I don't screw up from here on out. Yeah, we totally got this. As long as I don't botch the last result. Yeah, we totally got it. Alright, we are now captain! And we still are undefeated! And we get a priest stone. That'll come into play later on. Jerk. Don't know how you two are friends, though. Admittedly, I can be kind of a jerk to mine sometimes. Alright, Riku, what you gotta say to have for yourself? But you can pretty much get grinding off of those priest stones later on. Those things will come into play very soon, so I usually do race Riku about a couple of times and I really botched it. Alright, climb that ladder. I don't think he'll ever climb that ladder, so you don't have to worry about him taking the zip line. And provided you don't screw it up like I did. You can just platform your way across and I already botched it. Or not, since Riku usually waits or walks his way back. Oh wow, he didn't take the upper platform this time. Ah no! No, he totally got this one. Oh no way, he's walking! Come on, I can- Nope, no priest stone this time. priest stones can sell and you get some nice money out of it, so there is a bit of value if you're interested in that. But you can't get experience from Riku anymore, so that option's out of the window. Anyway, now that we have the name of the ref, we need to go get food. And Kyrie again has the list. This time we can't prepare it like we usually do. So you do need to talk to Kyrie to finish the list in one go. I have that. Totally have that. Two coconuts. Three fish, got it. And drinking water. Not from the ocean. Considering how dense Sora gets sometimes, that's pretty important to let him know. Alright, get that last mushroom we need. Play around with this little seesaw. And get some drinking water. And with that, we should be good to go. Let's go ahead and backtrack and call it in once again. So what is she? It looks like she's making something, but it kind of also looks like that she's twiddling her fingers. Oh well. Oh, what? I'm missing something? Oh, that's right, the coconuts! Okay, coconuts you can get over here. Unfortunately, you have to- Oh, hey, first try! Gotta wait for the yellow one to show up. Any tree will do, as long- But you have to wait for a yellow coconut, because for some reason, yellow coconuts are preferred. Oh. Alright, come on, which one is it? It's always random, so you don't always expect it, and I could have grabbed that one, couldn't I? Oh, got it. Got the two coconuts. Not a big fan of them, but I'll go ahead and bring them. And get an Erhyde potion. Alright. Yeah, let's go ahead.
Changed. What do you mean? Well, you okay? Sora, let's take the raft and go. Just the two of us.
Huh? This is your chance, man.
Just kidding.
Never mind.
You're the one that's changed, Kyrie.
Maybe. You know, I was a little afraid at first, but now I'm ready. No matter where I go or what I see, I know I can always come back here. Right?
Yeah, of course.
That's good. Sora, don't ever
change.
I just can't wait. Once we set sail, it'll be great.
Not quite sure how to answer those questions given what happens later on. In fact, so much stuff what happens later on kind of makes most of the first game redundant. Now we have a look at that letter. It also has one of my little favorite tunes from the game, or the entire series. Alright, a little bit of instructions. You should know who the king is at this point. If you grew up with Disney anyway.
Oh dear, what could this mean? It means we'll just have to trust the king.
Go on, I sure hope he's all right.
Your Highness, don't worry. We'll find the king and the king.
Thank you.
both of you.
Dashing, can you take care of them?
Of course. You be careful now, both of you.
Oh, and to chronicle your travels, he will accompany you.
Over here!
Just when you think they stopped pulling material.
Jiminy Cricket, at your service.
We hope for your safe return. Please, help the king.
He did say we, after all.
Gosh, Jiminy, your world disappeared too? It was terrible. We were scattered. And as far as I can see, I'm the only one who made it to this castle.
Don't you?
Oh, right. I gotcha. You mean while we're in other worlds, we can't let on where we're from, huh? We gotta
and
protect the
that
border.
Rule kinda gets broken from later on. And that, like, that's probably, like, the one thing you'll really notice with this game compared to every other game in the franchise. Like, don't make note of specific rules that they insist that the gang must follow, but in the end it kind of becomes moot. And to be fair, given the events that happen in those games, I'm pretty sure they... It's kind of like makes sense why that whole rules and everything become pointless later on. Kind of a dumb reason, I guess, but that's still something worth noteworthy. Like how much this whole thing has like the Mickey Mouse vibe. The gear and the handlebar, even the whole glove and even the whole little shuttle right there has the whole Mickey Mouse insignia. Away! Or not. I keep forgetting how much humor this game has compared to the others, and I know that's like a big comparison, but really, that doesn't drive the whole point in soon enough.
I just can't wait.
Also, make a quick note of this room, and this room in particular.
A storm? Oh no! The raft!
Well, that's one way to sneak out. Assuming you know you're not from a two-story building and everything.
What's that? Riku's boat! And Kairi's!
Those guys look familiar, don't you think? Now, as much as you want to do this, you can't do a thing to these guys. Apparently wood does not matter or does not register. So all we can do is just run and look around. Can't go there, so don't bother yet. If you're for some reason any danger, just remember that you can always go in here for a safe zone. And for some reason the Heartless these guys don't like water. So consider these your two main safe zones. And usually what you're supposed to do is just run through the bridge and You have no choice but to take the bridge. Huh. Alright, time to take that bridge. Just ignore these guys for now. You'll get your chance for revenge. Even they took away that barrel, too. Just leave alone, but we see Riku in the distance. Let's go talk to her. Excuse me?
Where's Kairi? I thought she was with you.
The door.
Oh hey, Birth by Sleep. Welcome along the stream. And don't worry, I hate ads too.
We gotta find Kairi.
Kairi's coming with us. Once we step through, we might not be able to come back. We may never see our parents again. There's no turning back.
You got that right.
But this may be our only chance. We can't let fear stop us. I'm not afraid of the darkness.
Now come with me, Sora.
Riku.
Am I excited for E3? Actually, I kind of forgot when E3 was about to start, but I'll make a mental note of that because there are a lot of things I want to see at E3. Right now? Sora hesitates, and Riku can't be seen. Parents? Well, to be fair, they don't see the parents ever again. But a bright light shows up, and we have a key! Now we've become official locksmiths! It also makes do for a nice sword. Now that we have our so-called Keyblade, we can do something about these guys. Throwing all that experience you got, you should be able to handle yourself, no problem. These little guys generally drop some health orbs, but they can also drop items like potions or high potions if you're really lucky. I'm pretty well stocked up, so I don't need to go out of my way to level up for these guys, but it's a nice little thing to know. Also, just remember, unlike the friendly fight you had with the Final Fantasy crew, this time you will go. That is actually a pretty legitimate question later on. In fact, how much does he hide? Cause like, let's take this into consideration. Later games he done that. Well, right now he's pretty much away from it, so talking is out of the question. But later on, that does become a legitimate question. Or is he old enough to take care of himself at that point? Oh well. We got our key, let's go open that door. Now we have entrance, and let's explore. Can't go through that back as much as I wanted to. Pretty sure it's a safe bet that the raft is destroyed anyway. Now we have plot though.
Sora.
Catch her in. Oh, God. And that's one way to catch her, Sora. Trip.
Whoa.
The whole place wrecked the porn, and we have our giant shadow to thank for that. And that's one way to interpret that scene. Anyway, we have a rematch with our giant shadow. This time he opens up with that little laser. Just hit it back like last time, and you get some free experience. Alright, I'm actually gonna stay on the ground. There we go, that's how I usually get. If you don't fancy yourself for doing that, you can hit the arms at will. One thing to point out, unlike last time or the dream sequence, if you lose all your health, you are dead. So definitely consider using an item if you need to. Get out of the way! And same thing as before, run up to that arm, and then just bash him in the head. Free experience and a bunch of damage. Your arm also counts, but doesn't deal as much to the head. He does have one new attack though, which you'll actually summon Dark Orbs. I am currently running this in Expert difficulty. Oh wait, actually he has two of them! He'll punch the ground and have his face down there, but this leads into that dark ball attack that I mentioned earlier. You punch the head as much as you can, keep hitting the arms, just stay aggressive. This is an Expert run of Kingdom Hearts. In fact, this is actually the original version of Kingdom Hearts, not 1.5 Remix. Just I throw that out there. But once those balls come on the loose, stay moving so you don't get hit by them. Becky should drop that bomb. Now let's go ahead and chase that arm. You should be able to finish this fight in like two or three cycles. Or I can finish it in two cycles and get a level up. Sweet. Not that bad of a boss fight, and you should be fine as long as you're well prepared and leveled up. Now we're stuck in a hurricane and... Sorry Sora, but not even boards can save you this time. That letter was true. And you can only imagine how many worlds were sucked up by those guys if that was the case. When does stream end? Well, it usually ends right when... Normally I usually end when I finish a specific segment, but because this is an RPG... I want to cut it off when we hit a specific point in each stream. So there's not really a set time limit. I could go on as long as midnight or even 2, as noted by the last stream. So because this is an RPG, I want to keep going until we hit a specific plot. In this case... Well, if you played this game before, you will know what I mean. So kind of think of each stream session as like a little arc from an anime or cartoon if you want. But anyway, getting back on action. Looks like we're in somewhere else.
Do you know where we are?
No, but I hear food. Now we're all alone. All alone, in the middle of nowhere. Well, except for that guy. Let's get a move on. Well, Sora, you've got your wish. Welcome to Travis Town. Pretty much a pretty big, nice little hub world of sorts. Let's go ahead and talk with the locals, see what they have to say. Oh, birth by sleep. I have yet to touch on that, even though I do have 2.5 final mix. She really should get to that after getting through everything on Kingdom Hearts 2. Alright, what do you gotta say? I guess... That's good to know. I know what that lady says true. No matter what you want to do, those candles will come back to life. Or you date. Oh, no, wait. It's usually if you hit all of them. Hit all of them, and they still come back. Anyway. Let's go ahead and look around. I don't think you can open this chest yet. Yeah, no, you can't open it. Let's go ahead and look around. Have a couple of new people. Weird little mark. Favorite world is Travis. I like Traverse Town too, but at the same time, there's a lot of worlds, and I usually have a favorite world for each game, so it's really hard to pinpoint which one's my all-time favorite. But anyway, going around, we're a little locked off. There's a first district. Let's go inside the store and see what they have to say. Very nice place, not gonna lie. And hi there, Final Fantasy guest number 4. Oh, you have no idea. Alright, sit here. You pretty much have introduction to shops. If you have money, you can go ahead and buy some stuff, but we don't really have anything. But if you go up in here, you get a mystical shard. Get used to seeing treasure chests and explore around. Here we have a little save point to work with, and you know what, I'm gonna go ahead and save. It's been quite a while since I've last saved, so let's not go overboard. Also, keep an eye out for stuff like this. Anyway, you can buy some stuff from Sid, like protect chains and everything. Accessories as a whole usually increase your defense, but they can also increase other stats. They're pretty expensive though, and we're broke, so don't expect to be able to do anything with that. But with that pretty stone we got last time, we get some dirty money. Still not enough to get anything, but it helps to get started. Alright, we have our main goal. Let's go ahead and look for our two buddies. Even though we kinda saw what happened to one of them. There's still a couple of things we can do around town though, so I want to get those out of the way before we take care of anything else. Push this crate right here, go ahead and climb up. We are now on the roof. Open up this chest to get a little postcard. And you saw that little mailbox right there? We'll come back to that in a bit. Now, if you're fast enough, do a quick attack. You can reach this area. Unfortunately, there's nothing here. So it's kind of a waste of time. What does this guy have to say? Find where I need the... What do you have to say, Moogle? Ooh, I'll be sure to come back to that when you get going. Nothing new, have a bit of a postcard adventure, but let's go ahead and explore real quick. There is a whole set thing that you can do in this world, but I want to go ahead and explore it. Yeesh, brutal. And we meet up with a new enemy. Oh, nope, we're back to old familiar faces. These guys are back in full force, but they now drop money, so make sure you pick up any orbs that you see. Layer abilities will make life a lot easier with these guys. And they also drop rare items that you will want to hold on to. So make sure you go out your way and fight some enemies. Also, there is a treasure chest and it froze. I was about to say try and refresh the page if that happens. Cause on my end it seems to be going through pretty fine. Yeah, it's going through really fine on my end. Anyway, open up that chest and you should get a postcard. Yeah, got a postcard. But anyway, from this district on, you pretty much run into Heartless You run into other enemies as well, so keep your guard up. And Donald and Goofy are still trying to look for us. Gotta say, I really do enjoy this theme though. And usually enemies do show up here, so... Might be a little... It's a little weird not seeing enemies. keep your guard up, they'll appear anywhere, and they can do damage. Now what you can do is keep exploring, or head back to go see Sid. Me, I want to explore a little to see what I can find. Because there's a bunch of goodies you can get right now, and I'd rather get them soon. Plus, these usually lead into different interactions between Donald and Goofy. Ah, jeez. Hang on. Grab some money. Gets a lot easier to build up money later on, so don't worry too much if you're not making any headway. I think I can make that jump. Ah, I had it. More enemies, try to pick up the orbs as fast as you can. Don't worry too much if you're not having any items, because if you beat those enemies, you get a lot of stuff back. Anyway, I don't think we can get that treasure chest quite yet. With that said, let's go ahead and check out the building next to it. The Gizmo Shop. Not here, that's for sure. Here we have more enemies and very short platforms that Sora can't jump on. The Gizmo Shop is home to a bunch of enemies, so keep this place under wraps if you want to level up a bit, or if you're in the mood for fighting enemies. You also have a chance of running into dropping lucid shards, so if you're into collectibles, be sure to fight these guys and see if you feel lucky. Again, later abilities will make your life a lot easier, particularly if you went with the shield. At least if you're playing the original game, not Final Mix. Again, Final Mix changes things up a lot, so you are going to have to deal with that. That's a shame. But anyway, carrying on. We have another house. Let's go ahead and check this out. So close yet so far. And now we get a little bit of a giant side quest. You know the story between 101 Dalmatians? Well, let's bring that family back together. You can look around the house if you want, but I'm gonna go back and continue to explore. Now, I believe there is one more skit you can see between Donald and Goofy in this area. At least as far as I know. Like, if you enter the hotel, you enter the Gizmo Shop, and if you enter a particular area in the second district, you pretty much get to see little skits. Rock up some health. Let this little baddie come to me. And let's go into that alleyway. Here it seems. Alright, in the alleyway. I don't remember if you can pick up a couple of goodies here. Oh, you totally can. Let's go ahead and check that out. These guys should not be a problem, especially if you've been leveling up really efficiently. But even if you haven't, this is a good place to build up experience, unless you're doing a little level run. Go over here for a free potion. Carry this little crate. We can climb on those rooftop runs, a la Sonic. We carry a little crate, climb aboard, and we get another treasure chest. This one drops a priest stone, which we can sell back for some more money. I believe there's another treasure chest you can get right now. Yeah, there it is, right there. And if you open this one up, we get another potion. Let's drop on down and... or get stuck on those handrails, or those little flags. Oh man, Heartless Iron. Again, these guys should not pose much of a threat. Most, if not all, we can do at the moment. Gonna wreck some enemies here. Come on in the shadow. Keep an eye on where those marks, they'll come into play later on. That path leads back to the Dalmatians, so if you want to visit them again, you can go through there. I think you were supposed to go through there, but I didn't do that anyway. Alright, there's still one more district we can go to, but at this point in time, it doesn't lead into anything except new enemies. So we should be alright for now. And with all these enemies ramping about, let's go ahead and... Sorry. Let's head back to the first district and talk to Sid. Looks like... so much for being the safest area in the... in Traverse Town. You run around, you can fight most of these enemies if you want. Which makes for good money, but... really and truly, aside from that, you have no reason to not go drop by and see Sid if that's your main goal. Come on, hop out of the ground. Only annoying things about these guys is that they drop down and hide for a while, so you can't exactly combo them. Anyway, let's go ahead and see Sid. Sid, I need help. Yeah, sure, agreed. But I'm also mainly here to sell this priest stone that we found in the alleyway. Get some more money. We do have enough to go buy a protect chain, but I want to hold off on that for a while. For now though, let's go ahead and save. Because we have a little event we can do right now.
They'll come at you out of nowhere.
Who are you?
And they'll keep on coming at you, as long as you continue to wield the Keyblade. But why? Why would it choose a kid like you?
Hey!
Hello, get Final Fantasy guest number 5.
Never mind. Now, let's see that Keyblade.
What? There's no way you're getting this!
Alright. Then have it your way.
Hey, Squall. We have a fight with Squall! Squall has two main strategies. Generally, if you can get behind him, you can combo him and launch him pretty far. If you can't do that though, you're better off staying moving. Just jump over. You can take his gun blade. Usually has two options, either jumping and striking you. And I'm gonna go ahead and heal because I do not want to lose this fight. Come on, shoot your fire. Just like with Waka Blitzball, you hit the fire, he'll be stunned. Then get behind him and do big damage to him. You can also hide behind areas and use the area to your advantage if you don't like fighting up close and personal. Squall will usually jump towards you, so don't bother running, or he'll slowly walk towards you. Again, if you don't like flying up close, you can use the fire to your advantage, and take advantage of those times when Squall's down to reposition yourself. Ooh, a little late on that draw. But with that, you level up and win with Squall. But we still lose anyway.
Oh, you're slipping, Leon.
Hello there, guest number 6.
I went easy on him. Looks like things are worse than we thought. A lot worse.
Gosh, there's nobody here. Sure is spooky.
Actually, I'm not scared.
Maybe you are now.
Excuse me, did the king send you?
You can kind of tell who made the game now, didn't you?
Come on, lazy bum. Wake up. You okay?
I guess.
Those creatures that attacked you are after the Keyblade. But it's your heart they really want. Because you wield the Keyblade.
That's a pretty scary thing to just dump on someone.
Kairi, who are you talking about? I'm the great Ninja Yuffie.
Hello there.
I think you might have overdone it, Squall.
That's Leon.
The Keyblade.
Yeah, we had to get it away from you to shake off those creatures. It turns out, that's how they were tracking you.
It was the only way to conceal your heart from them. But it won't work for long. Still, hard to believe that you, of all people, are the chosen one.
Oh.
Well, I suppose beggars can't be choosers.
Why don't you start making sense? What's going on here?
Okay. You know there are many other worlds out there.
There's only one little tiny detail I have about this game that sort of bugs me. And it's something that kind of switches around.
Because they've never been connected. Until now. When the Heartless came, everything changed.
The Heartless?
Like, okay, like, just to keep it brief and everything, like, look at the characters' faces.
The darkness in people's
like, it's really apparent with Sora, especially when you look at earlier cutscenes when the whole...
Within every heart.
Hey, have you heard
when the eyes were a lot more fluid and expressive, as opposed to this cutscene where everyone's kind of static looking right now.
He recorded all of his
like,
findings.
I know it's a really weird way and a little buggy detail to point out, but that's just the only thing that bugs me.
Too many worlds.
Especially with the way that the game presented itself early on. Like, I'll point it out when we get a different cutscene, but I'll leave it at that till then.
We've gotta find him quick.
That's right. The Keyblade.
So, this is the key.
Exactly.
The Heartless have great fear of the Keyblade. That's why they'll keep coming after you, no matter what.
Well, I didn't ask for this.
The Keyblade chooses its master, and it chose you.
So, tough luck.
How did all this happen? I remember being in my room.
Think back
a
little.
What happened to my home? My island? Riku! Kairi!
You know what? I really don't know.
Well, that's one way to tell someone that. Alright, back to the main point. A little bit of the lore behind Kingdom Hearts. And that's Kinda nothing to standard, but if we try opening this chest, it's locked. Go ahead and talk to Yuffie. Now let's try that again. Now that we pretty much recognize that we are officially locksmiths, we can open up keyholes. And in that treasure chest, there's the Megalixir. And we saw a bunch of locked keyholes throughout the entire town. So that's something to consider. Anyway, other thing that you want to do, keep an eye on this clock. Strike it with your keyblade. Keep striking. Then you'll hear a little chime. But I am not satisfied. Keep striking. Come on, a couple more times. And we have another chime. Once you hear that, you're pretty much done, and I'll explain why later. Go back here. We get a Mistral. Also, we can actually look at these paintings. Time flies. What about this one? They're just pretty neat stuff. What do you gotta say, Yuffie? Mm-hmm. Same stuff. And if we try to bail... fine. What do you gotta say, Squall? Kinda figured as much. Well, it's not like I have any other option.
Yuffie, go!
Yuffie!
Sora, let's go!
That's one way. That's one way to get out. Or Sora could just take the stairs. Forgetting how funny this game can get sometimes. Alright, Leon. I'll take you up on your offer. Now we have a couple of new enemies, and now we actually know that these guys are actually called the Heartless. With that said, now I can go into a little bit more detail rather than just give out some spoilers, even though I've kind of already done that a number of times. These Heartless in particular are called Soldiers. And they're a lot stronger than the shadows that we've been fighting. I am not dying to this! Anyway, soldiers. A little stronger variant with a lot more defense and more attack. The biggest thing that you have to worry about is their kicks, especially the little charge kick they have. If you hit them during the charge, you should be fine, and you can cancel the whole effect. Other things that you need to watch out for is their spin kick, which you can parry, but you need like precise timing. Like that kick, if you hit them during the charge, you should be safe. If you went with the sword or a shield, you should be able to take them down like 2 or 3 or 4 combo attacks. But if you went with the staff like I did, or the shield, or just plain gave up the sword, you kind of have your work cut out for you. The good thing about fighting soldiers though is that they drop a lot of money, so definitely take your time to fight them. And remember, the first district is always a safe zone. So if you're feeling outmatched, running away is still a viable option. And also getting a little squared in. Sweet, get some money. We won't be running into those shadows that we've been fighting with earlier for quite some time. So you're mainly gonna deal with these soldiers for a good chunk of the game right now. The main place that we haven't been dealing with though is the existence of... Actually, hold on a second. Okay, we're back. Sorry about the whole delay. Kind of realized that I left something on and I should turn it off. Other thing that you should know about soldiers is that they drop spirit shards, which are also key ingredients for synthesis. And you won't be able to get them or anywhere else for a while, so definitely take that into consideration. Let's see. One other thing you might want to start doing is get in the habit of making sure Sora is loaded with items. They'll come into play later on and you'll be glad that you did. But before we move on, let's go back to the first district. Our main destination is third, but I want to head back. Remember what Yuffie said about the locks? Well, we can open that up right now. Alright, Leon's pretty much won't tell you that coming here is always a good idea. Get yourself a postcard from winning that little safe right here. And we've stocked up quite a bit of items now. So let's go ahead and go to this little mailbox right here. Box number one, you get a cottage. Fully heals you up and you don't need to go to a save point. Second postcard gives you a Mithril shard. Always a good thing to have. Third postcard gives you a mega potion. This heals everyone in the field for 30%, and while that's great for Sora, it gets even better later on, so definitely hold on to that. You talk to Yuffie, she'll pretty much point you in the right direction, so you don't have to worry about getting lost or something. But anyway, you go ahead and talk to Aeris, you get a Mega Potion. And again, if you talk to Aeris and Yuffie, they'll roughly point out where you need to go, so you don't have to worry about getting lost, except for one particular area, which I'll get to later. Anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and take out one of those mega potions we got, and go ahead and save. Yeah, we should be okay for now. Yeah, we should be alright. Alright, we're fully loaded, we saved, and we got our items ready to go. One other thing I should mention about this game in particular in the original version. This game does have a soft reset. If you hold L, both all shoulder triggers and push start and select, you'll do a soft reset and find yourself back at the title screen. Really helpful if you don't want to reset the console. And this and one other game in the series are the only ones that I know that do have the soft reset trick. So there's that for exploits, or if anything. Or as I like to call it, the manual reset. Go ahead and bash a couple soldiers. Maybe help out later on. Get rid of shadows. No item drops, so I guess that's out of the equation. Alright. Couple more enemies. Let's go ahead and bash them knock down real quick. I am more worried about the soldier than anyone else right now. Ah, gets a cheap shot on me. Sure, they get the cheap shot once their last hit too. But now we're here at the third district. I think you can enter this house. Oh, no, you can't. So let's go ahead and look for that leader. Hey, Goofy.
Gosh, are these the heartless guys?
Looks like it. Or Donald can remember that he's Donald. And, well, need I say any more? In. Time to fire our way out, but we have buddies on our side. Donald and Goofy join alongside us. And we have more information to take care of. Donald is a mage and Goofy is a knight. Since Donald knows fire, he can pretty much one-shot a lot of the enemies, but he's also very frail, so keep an eye on him. They're also loaded with items, so you usually don't have to worry about having to heal them, because they'll usually do a good job of healing themselves. Goofy is a knight. He has a shield to block certain attacks, as well as generally lasts longer compared to Donald. So as a whole, Donald might get a little outshined early on. But now, we have an awesome battle theme and a new boss in the form of the Guard Armor. What do you want to do? Back off real quick, and then try to hit the armors to tech for some free experience. Stay jumping and moving because his attacks hurt for this particular phase. Each body of the arm has its own HP. The arms are its biggest source of strength, and they also have the smallest amount of HP out of the entire system. By destroying each part, you get some health, so don't be afraid to Oh man. Kind of getting cut in mid-sentence. What you usually like to do is go for the arms, wait for it to start spinning, and then hit it. Biggest concern right now is Donald, considering how frail he is, and the fact that he only knows fire, which is great on the small enemies, but not so great on the main bosses. One little thing I like to point out is that if you push the triangle button while you're locked on, your teammates Donald and Goofy will usually focus on that target. We're in trouble. Yeah, that mega potion I kept heals the entire crew, which is perfect. Come on, Donald. Alright, both arms destroyed, we don't have to worry about the spin attack. What we do need to worry about is the legs and the torso. When the torso is by itself, it gets a new attack. Now for the most part, you can pretty much counter everything that the guard armor does, so don't feel threatened when it starts going on the offense. A well-timed strike will protect you and give you some much-needed time to take care of some enemies. Don't worry too much if Don and Goofy do go down though. Because unlike Sora, give them a little bit of time and they'll come back to life. Or they'll wake up. Alright, go for a jump. Gah! I might need a heal. Just jump a little. Keep an eye on the main body. When it's alone, it gets a new attack. If you can get some shots in. Keep an eye on the main body. When it starts to shake, you want to jump. And I got incredibly lucky there. Oh good, we got some health orbs. Now all we have to worry about is the main body, and it gets a spin attack. You cannot interrupt the first few frames of the spin attack. So let's start spinning, and then you can strike it for a free counter. Otherwise, you just want to keep your distance. But if you do manage to stop it, like so, you get a free shot, but we level up and get some new abilities. It is very easy to die to the guard armor, but as long as you're careful and mindful of your spacing, and if you're good at parrying, you can not only build up a lot of experience, but make the fight easier on yourself. But anyway, taking care of this guy gives us the Brave Warrior, free accessory, and more plot.
So, you were looking for me?
They too have been seeking the wielder of the Keyblade.
Hey, why don't you come with us? We can go to other worlds on our vessel.
I wonder if I could find Riku and Kairi.
Even if we don't know what you're talking about.
Who knows? But we need them to come with us to help us find the king.
Sora, go with them. Especially if you want to find your friends.
Yeah, I guess.
But you can't come along looking like that. Understand? Ooh. No problem. No shot, friends. Okay?
Yeah, you gotta look funny. Like us.
That is an odd rule to give.
Happy?
Okay, that's kind of creepy, but also take note of Sora's face for that matter. Like, this cutscene right here, Sora looks natural, or how he done. And then right there, he's no longer natural or cartoony anymore!
I'm Sora.
I know it's the first game in the series and everything, but still, that does bug me a little. I'm probably the only person I know that cares about that tiny detail. Oh well. Still enjoy the game, regardless.
That little squirt took down that Heartless. Who'd have thought it? Such is the power of the Keyblade. The child's strength is not his own.
Why don't we turn him into a Heartless? Ha ha ha! That'll settle things quick enough.
And the black friends of a king's lackeys. Slug on the eyes, they're all Bill's rats by the look of them.
You're no prize yourself.
Shut up!
Enough!
Looks like we have our own little Sinister Six right here.
Has chosen him. Will it be he who conquers the darkness? Or will the darkness swallow him? Either way, he could be quite useful.
Okay, one little thing before we... I know I'm jumping the gun a little bit, but if you are playing 1.5 Remix of Kingdom Hearts, or Final Mix for that matter, you have one additional cutscene that showcases that involves Riku in a particular location. Turns out our little buddy's been lost too, but we don't get to see it in this game. And I thought I'd cover it because, well, Final Mix is out, and even though I'm not playing it for this run through, I figure I should try and cover as much as I can. Awesome! Been needing this money. And for winning the fight with Leon, you get another free elixir. Acknowledged, and will do. You certainly developed that experience in your game, didn't you, Squall? But now we have a ship! Much better than a raft! But the gifts continue. We now have magic, which means all that magic I have is now useful! Oh, and Goofy also gives us... We have money, we have items, and we learn two abilities. Scan and the dodge roll. This is more of an action ability rather than a support ability. And quit stealing my lines, guys. And we have a little journal. So yeah, Donald and Goofy are now following us. And I already covered their main intro, but I'll cover them again the next time that we get into this. But anyway, one little thing we can take a look at. Donald fights with Stannis, Goofy fights with shields. And that accessory have the Brave Warrior kind of fits Goofy more, so I tend to give it to him. But now we have a couple of abilities we can work with. Sora has skin. Your first ability will always come at level 9, and it will vary depending on what you picked. If you picked the sword and shield, since I picked the staff, I get scan. If you picked the shield and the sword, you would learn something different. But regardless of what you picked, you will always learn all the abilities in the game. You just get them at later points. The staff gets a weird fusion of both support and combat abilities, but it ultimately learns the useful combat abilities at the end. Scan pretty much lets you see the health bar, and you get a whole evasive maneuver in the form of dodge roll. Goofy, on the other hand, learned Rocket for quite some time, and he learns Jackpot. from the belt, the guard armor. Gonna go ahead and equip them all so we can get treasure hunting a lot easier. Donald, you idiot! You had items and you didn't bother to use them! Couple of things that we can also work with involve basically setting the overall AI with the teammates. But because I don't want to go too much into details, I'll save this for later. In fact, we are almost going to be done for this episode of streaming Kingdom Hearts, but I do want to cover some little details before we take care of going off. Basically, if you see these marks, hit up the Trinity command, and we have a teleportation. Trinities are your only way of getting certain items or accessing new areas, so be sure you have Donald and Goofy at all times, especially when you have the option to switch. But coming here gives us a postcard. And we saw another mark not that far from here. Also, pushing square lets us run. Going over here, we get more money and a bit of a couple of goodies. Just keep rolling around. Not quite 100 money, but a good chunk anyway. This area is still closed off, but now that we know that the keyblade unlocks keyholes, we're still pretty good to go. Oh. Alright, good. I'll dwell into personality later, but the Heartless should be gone for now, so you don't have to worry about them for a while. Also, even though you see different kinds of marks, you can only do blue, so don't mess with the other training marks at the moment. Let's go ahead and climb out. There's still a couple of secrets we can get. Some of which are beneficial, others are just purely for show. Like, let's see here. One secret you can do right now involves one of the hotel rooms. Actually, I don't think we can do one particular secret at the moment, which is kind of a shame because I was looking forward to showing it off. I do plan on taking care of it at one point, but I guess we won't be doing it right now. Yeah, we can't do it right now. But if you go into the red room, we get another shot of getting another Breastone. Get it? Again, the beginning is awfully very generous when it comes to money, even if you don't go out of your way to exploit to get some goodies. Anyway, what else is here? I know there's like another goodie you can get right now. Also, I totally missed the cutscene. Or an optional cutscene. And I don't think I can watch it. I'll go back and see if I can find it, but I don't think I can. Alright. Other things that we can do right now. If we go back to the gizmo shop, that ladder that we saw earlier should be fixed by now, so we can go get some extra goodies. The platforms are still down, so we can't do much other than just explore for a little bit. What I plan on doing for now is go ahead and get some goodies and then call it in. I'll delve into more specific parts the next time we stream, which can be pretty random, I'm not gonna lie. There's another red training mark, we can't do anything about it though. But now that we have access to the roof, we have access to a couple of goodies. Two of which I'll get into later. Alright, run across some rooftops. I just love dodge roll because it's so much faster than some of the other stuff that we're used to. But anyway, now that we're here, don't go back in the second district! This was a little alleyway that we saw Donald and Goofy from. But we're here for two reasons. Go over here, we get a postcard. Jump off said platform, we're in front of the keyhole. Open it, we have a shortcut to the first district now. This particular thing becomes important later on, but right now just remember where it is. And if we go back here, we have a Trinity mark. filled with more money and goodies. And this should be a camping set. Yep, camping set. Now, in Kingdom Hearts, you have some final familiar items to Final Fantasy veterans in the form of tents, camping sets, and cottage. Tents fully heal the entire party from the main menu. Camping sets does the same thing, but also gives you 3 MP before using it. And the cottage lets you restore all your health and magic for free, all without having to go to a save point. If you go here, pretty empty. Just remember where it is, though. Getting a little sleepy, but I can manage. And I think that's the most we can do at the moment. What they really want you to do is go ahead and explore and stock up for your next destination. As far as I know, that's all the Blue Trinities and postcards you can get at this point in the game. You can't get all of them until midway, so don't worry about missing them. And they're not permanently missable, so again, don't worry if you miss out a couple items at this point, you'll be fine. Anyway? Yeah, I totally missed the conversation you could have had right afterwards. Basically, the conversation you would have had was you could talk to Squall and he would mention the Dalmatians quest for you. So if you didn't visit the house and you were wondering what it was there for, Squall can tell you. And Donald, really? Oh well. Sending the postcard, we get a Mega Easter. Sending that fifth postcard we get a Mistral. I don't think you can get any more than 5, so... Oh wait, no, actually I'm wrong, you can totally get more than 5. Forgot about this one. But before we do that, these guys look familiar to you? Donald's nephews run the shop. And they also become a bit of an important place because this is where you can not only get items for Sora, but they're their main weapons, their main stop for weapons for Donald and Goofy. Sid mainly sells accessories, so you do have that to consider. But anyway, lock onto the fan, hit it, you get a free postcard. Now, usually you don't need to worry about items that much, especially for Donald, because most of his good items don't come until very late. But even so, you can usually get by, so you tend to have a choice between either getting items or accessories, and with the money I have, I think I could get both, no problem. And I think I'm seriously gonna call it in after all that. So that's what I'll probably do. I'll stock up on items and then call it in. Basically, let's go ahead and talk to Sid real quick. I said talk to Sid, not Robin. Let's sell. Oh, no, let's sell. Let's go and sell that Presto for some more money. But anyway, we now have a choice between a couple items. Admittedly, the Fire Ring is probably the most useful out of all of them. You can only buy 2 of them though. So... But even then, magic shouldn't be too bad. If you have at least one accessory, you should be fine. And I'll leave it at that. Let's go ahead and give Donald and Goofy some assess. Jeez. Donald needs all that. Screw giving that Goofy. Donald needs that defense. Forgot how bad Donald's defense was in this game. Alright, but the last bit I guess I'll do for today is just stop on here. Let's go ahead and buy some weapons for Donald and Goofy. Donald focuses on staff and Goofy focuses on shield. Now what you can buy though for both of them is what sells them. Donald usually has a choice between either focusing on magical abilities or focusing on sword abilities. What you can essentially do is try and balance things out if you pick something other than the sword, what Sora should or canonically picks in the dream sequence. So essentially, you can make Donald a warrior or Goofy a warrior, and vice versa. But I generally prefer playing at their strengths, with Sora being a balanced unit. And as for Goofy's particular case, I usually prefer having him as a tank unit. So I'll buy the shield for him. And Donald's Morning Star doesn't really change much for him. The Morning Star does give Donald an extra bit of strength, roughly around Sora's level, I think. Well, kinda Sora's level. But for Goofy, I tend to give him the stout shield. Alright, I think we're fully prepared. And I think we'll save going off into next time. So, was fully prepared, a new team, Sora nowhere. Actually, one more thing. Target, little quick practice with spellcasting. Lock onto the fireplace, fire. Cast fire. Now we have a working chimney. Alright, but you know what? I think that'll just about do it for this episode. We mainly got started with the quest. Riku and Kairi are nowhere near to be found after that whole incident at the island. We meet up with two Disney familiar faces. We have a key sword, or sword key if you want to call it. And we pretty much have our main objective. I think that's good enough for our main episode. And next time that we meet up, we will continue on and carry on that main journey. I'll also go ahead and delve on a little bit deeper with the main game mechanics. So, once again, thank you for coming, and I do plan on continuing Kingdom Hearts for quite a while, at least until I beat the game. And because this is an RPG, it's gonna be a little weird for me to try and get used to it, which is why I was a little hesitant to pick this game to begin with. But so far, I think it worked out pretty well, and I can go through the rest of the game pretty comfortably. Now that we got some more story info, I can start talking about a couple of other things as well. So, again, thank you very much for coming by and sticking around. I'll go ahead and post Linda next time we can stream, and from that point on, we'll either continue on with Kingdom Hearts, or we'll get started with a different game, because RPGs are kind of their own thing, and usually thing. I'll plan things out and let you guys know what to expect. So once again, thank you all very much for coming by, and I hope to see you guys next time, or when we come back to Kingdom Hearts. See you guys then!